In this video, we will find block diagram and transfer function of armature control DC motor. So this is the basic circuit diagram of armature control DC motor. So here we assume that the demagnetizing effect of armature reaction is neglected. Armature circuit is assumed linear. As this circuit is armature control DC motor, so the field voltage is constant, so field current is also constant. So this are the parameter VIA, RA, LA, and I already written that RA is the armature resistance, LA is the self induction, and etc. And T is the torque, theta is the armature angular displacement, J is the equivalent moment of inertia, and B is the equivalent coefficient of friction. So first of all, we apply Kvl equation in this circuit. So apply KVL. So you can write V equal to RAIA plus L into TIA by DT, and E. Here E is the induced EMF in armature. Okay. So I mark this first equations. Now, as the armature is rotating, so there is induced some EMF. So that EMF E is proportional to phi omega, where phi is the flux and omega is the angular frequency. Now we simplify that equation. So we can write KB1 phi into omega. As we consider this is the armature control DC motor, so its field current is constant. Field current constant means phi is also constant. So we replace this two constant by single constant, that KB into omega. So further we can write omega equal to d theta by dt. So finally we can write E equal to KB d theta by dt and put this equations as 2. Now coming to that torque portion. So the torque delivered by the motor will be the production of armature current and the flux. So T is directly proportional to the phi and IA. So now we replaced proportional by using one constant. So this is phi using K1 and IA. As we use that armature control DC motor, so phi will be constant. So phi is constant means as armature current is, field current is constant, so phi is also constant. So these two constant is replaced by one single constant, that is K. So finally we get the equation that K into IA. We put this equation as 3. And now we write that dynamic equations with moment of inertia and coefficient of friction. So that is T equal to J into d2 theta by dt2 plus B into d theta by dt. So I give that number 4 equation. So we have only 4 equation. By using that 4 equation, we have to draw that block diagram and also find that transfer function from the block diagram. First of all, we find the block diagram, and after that, we find the transfer function. So next step is we take Laplace transform all that 4 equation. So now take the Laplace transform of equation 1, 2, 3 and 4. So by applying Laplace equation, we can find that Vs equal to Ra into Ias plus L into S Ias plus Es, and we can write that Vs minus Es equal to, if we take common Ias, that will be R plus SLA. And second equation, that will be Es equal to KB S into theta S. Third equation will be TS equal to K into IAS. And number four equation will be TS equal to S square J theta S plus B into S into theta S. Now we take S theta S common, so the equation will be Sj plus B. So we get another four equation in frequency domain, means level frequency domain. So we mark that equation, this is A, this is B, this is C, and this is D. So using this four equation, we will draw that block diagram. So let's start. Now we will draw the block diagram of each equation. So from first equation, we can draw that block diagram like that. So this is the Vs, this is input, and minus Es, so this will be minus, so this will be Es, and there is some gain, that is 1 by Ra plus SLA, and this will be Ia. So you can see that this is Vs minus Es. Okay, so Vs minus Ef multiplied with 1 by Rs plus Sa, we get that Ia current. So this equation is, we write that this equation is correct. Now in second equation, we write that this is Kb and this is S theta S is input, and this is output as Es. So you can see from here we can write Es equal to KBS theta S. So this block diagram matching with our previous equations. And third equation, we write that this will be TS. It also matching that equations. Now, and last and final block diagram of this equation will be B plus Sj, this will be S theta S, and input will be Ts. So you can see S theta S equal to Ts into 1 by B plus Sj, that matching that equations. So we get the four block diagram of each four equations. Now we combine this four block diagram into one diagram. So let's start do that. So this is our Vs as the input. You have to remember that here Vs is the input and the theta S, means angular displacement, is the output. So Vs is input and theta S is output. So now we draw that block diagram. So first of all, this is ES. So we get that VS minus ES, and it gives one block diagram, that 1 by RA plus S into LA, that's output is IA. You can see that output IA, if we combine that, then it combine with that number 3 block diagram. So IA, if we multiply K, that it will give TS. Now TS is combined that equation. So B plus SJ, and the output is S theta S. Now S theta S into KB gives ES. So this will be KB and it S. So you can see that if it is very easy, if you draw the block diagram of each equation and finally combine all this equation. So here we get S theta S. Actually we have to get theta S. So if we multiply 1 by S, then we get that theta S. So this is the whole block diagram of the armature control DC motor. Now you can easily find that the transfer function of the system by using block diagram reduction technique. So let's start. So here we perform one rule, basic rules of block diagram, that moving a takeoff point after the block diagram. Okay, so after performing that rule, we find that block diagram like that, plus minus, this is Vs, 1 by RA plus S into LA, this is K, this is 1 plus B plus SJ, this will be 1 by S, S, KB, and back to the. If you don't know how it comes, then come to my previous lecture and follow that block diagram reduction rule. So you can easily find that how this portion is coming. So now performing that second portion, these all are in series. So that again will be multiply with each other. So this will be Vs, and it will be K by S into RA plus SLA into J SJ plus B, and it will be theta S, and it will be SKB. Now it is normal that negative feedback closed loop, so we can easily write that theta S by Vs equal to, I write that final equation, you find all the calculations, K by RA plus SLA JS plus B into S plus K KB into S. You know that the basic negative feedback formula, if there is G gain, and if there is some feedback gain block K, and if this is CS and this is the RS, then RS by CS will be GH divided by 1 plus GH. So by applying same formula, I find that equation. So this is the final transfer function of armature control DC motor. So in my next lecture, we will find that field control DC motor transfer function. Thank you for your attention. If you have any query, please comment on below video section. Thank you once again.